Welcome to another magic series. Thank you for that lovely welcome for me. I do hope you like my place. It's not much, but it's home. You know, Thames ran this up before breakfast for me. Lovely, isn't it? And they've promised me that if we get in the top five, they'll wallpaper it for me. Now, you may remember, ladies and gentlemen, that about this time last week, I asked you to tie a knot in your handkerchief to remind you to watch the show. Now, obviously, you did do that, because otherwise you wouldn't be watching. And you may be wondering what to do with your knots. Well, here's a suggestion. Just hold the handkerchief like this. Shush, don't put me on. Hold the handkerchief like this, and give it a little shake, and then possibly another little shake, and the knot will drop off. There's only one disadvantage. One tiny snag about this method is that it leaves you with a nasty great hole in the middle of handkerchiefs, so perhaps you better not try it. Now, I thought we might start this new series with a brilliant magician who is a magical specialist, and his name is John Clocks. He's here.
Thank you.
Thank you, John. And the name, ladies and gentlemen, is John Clocks, K-L-O-X. Thank you, John, very much. This is a record. It's a hit record. And it's one of the many hits written, produced, and performed by... Oh, she has to be the most beautiful songwriter in the business. And it's a pleasure to welcome Lynsey de Paul. Here's you. Just give a little jump, darling. That's it. A little jump and you'll be on. I am taller. These were made for size 13s.
Are they?
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
We haven't worked together since the Christmas show.
No, we haven't.
When you appeared with me.
When I disappeared with you.
Oh, let's see that little bit again. In the crystal casket. I love this bit. This was at Christmas. Do you remember when I put you in the crystal casket and hoisted you up into the air and I pointed out that there you were, hanging in space, surrounded by absolutely nothing, while you're trying to get up on the stool still. Surrounded by nothing, there you were. We could see you in the crystal casket.
I remember that.
And I asked you if you were feeling all right,
and
you waved to me. That's right. And then the flames kind of sprang from my fingers, and look!
I went into thin air.
You went into pieces. Oh. And I picked up the dress and it was still warm.
I never got it back, you know.
Didn't you?
No.
I wish I'd given you a lift home now. Lynsey, you've had a lot of successes even since then. That wasn't long ago. There's My Man and Me and, of course, your LP.
Yes.
And this one is always going to be my favourite. You know which one that is, don't
that
you?
That one. Yes, but that wasn't a gold disc.
It wasn't a gold disc?
No.
Would you have liked it to have been a gold disc?
I would have loved it.
Should have had a magician, you know.
Instead of a record company.
Instead of a record company. You got one of those too? Thread the gold through the middle there, and we do a little bit of magic. You would have liked a gold disc, all right? There's your gold disc, Lynsey. How's that?
You've got another record in there.
No! Another record?
You've got another record in there, I bet you.
No, honestly.
I thought you'd never say that.
I have to say it.
I've got to
tear it up. Look inside. No other record. How is that? Lynsey, obviously you're going to sing for us later on, but meanwhile, would you help me with an illusion? Actually, this is something that I first did for Granada Television.
Oh, you were suffering from illusions of Granada.
You could say that. You could say that.
I just said it.
Yes, you said it beautifully too. Actually, this isn't really so much an illusion as a piece of escapology.
Oh.
So, would you walk this way, please, as they say?
On a family show.
Yeah. Walk this way. Now, come over here, Lynsey. It's a very simple piece of apparatus, and it's rather exciting because this is brand new, you see. So I shall be the very first man to enter it. Let's open the curtain. What is...
What are you doing in there?
Well, I wanted to phone my agent, and I can't find the telephone anywhere.
This isn't a phone box.
Well, look, it's a very important message. Have you got a pigeon up your sleeve or something?
Oh,
because
no. You've never seen anything like this before, have you?
No, a brick wall with no graffiti. That's really stunning.
I wonder if you'd be kind enough to step over here, because I want to show Lynsey the ropes.
Yeah, right.
If you'll pardon, let me get over. Now, we've got two posts with holes through, and these ropes running through the middle, you see, like this. And I'm just going to straighten them up a bit, and the idea is that I shall stand here in the middle, all right, like this. This is what they call the British position.
Huh?
Backs to the wall.
Oh.
Both, these very kind, and tie me up. Just take a rope across.
Oh,
yeah. You do the top one.
I'm very tall.
Are you tall enough?
I'm very tall.
All right then, you start from there down, and you can do the ankles.
Yeah, but could you put your thumb on that one, please?
I can't put thumb on anywhere. Now pull it as tight as you like. Don't be frightened of stopping the gym circulation.
That's a very old-fashioned knot, this. It's a granny knot, this is called.
Steady. Right. Good. Now, that's
all this.
Sorry, that's fine. Just one more to go. One more round in each. This is very kind of you. Thank you so much. This will be a marvelous trick if it works. Right. Now, are you ready for the great escape?
Yes. Yes, your escapology is about... escapologize. Go on, that's the best thing. I was going to say, your escapology has been accepted.
I like
do
it.
Do it.
Get out of that.
Lindsay, I should be out before you can say social contract.
Don't say that. We'll all be out.
All right, then close the curtain, because I don't want to pull the curtain round. I don't want them to see how it's done, you see. Just pull the curtain right round.
Right the way round.
And right round the back as well. Pull it round the back, Rolf.
How far round?
That's it, right round. Pull it round and walk around with it, and you can open it up now. That's the way. Open it up.
Do you think you could leave me tied in?
I don't know about you, but we're going to have a little natural break. Don't go away, and don't you go.
A chance to be a fine thing.
Thank you, everybody. And welcome back. Welcome to the second spasm. I want to show you, ladies and gentlemen, a little bit of what is called in the trade psychometry. It's a little bit of psychology, a little bit of magic, a little bit of thought reading. I am going to read your thoughts. Well, some of them. You're looking worried already. I've got some envelopes here, about five of them. Would you like to look at those and see that they're unmarked? They're all in order. They're all exactly the same. No marks on there at all. All quite clear and plain. All right, would you like to have one of them? And may I ask you to have an envelope, madam? Yes. And perhaps this gentleman here behind you. You won't have to do anything embarrassing, I promise you. Would you take an envelope, sir? And perhaps over there, would you take an envelope? So we have five envelopes spread around, absolutely plain, straightforward, thick manila envelopes. Now, I would like these five people, if you'd be kind enough, just to put some little personal article. I'm very hard up this week, it's the first of the series. Some little personal article into the envelope, as small as you like. It can be a coin, it can be a key, it can be a handkerchief, it can be a £10 note. Some little personal article, and I promise you that I will not look and see what you are doing. I don't want to see what you are putting in the envelope, so I'm looking over here, and you can see that there are no monitors over there, so I'm not cheating. I am not watching what you're putting in the envelopes, and these ladies and gentlemen are not Confederates. That's word of honor. May I ask this gentleman here in the second row to give me a hand? Would you take this tray for me? Would you mind helping me?
No.
Most kind of you. A very simple thing you have to do. All you have to do is to collect the envelopes, you see. Will you stick them down for me, please? Well, if you wouldn't mind sticking them down, because it's a horrible taste, I don't want to do it myself. They're second hand. I'm awfully sorry. Stick them down, and then collect the envelopes. And will you please mix them up, sir, so that you can't possibly know where any particular envelope is. Thoroughly mix them up. Have a look at them, see that they're all the same. Mix them up. Now, I haven't seen what went into the envelopes, that's word of honor. Would you please now pick any envelope you like? Do you know where that came from? Can you possibly know? Right, and give it to me, and I am going to... You see, these things carry an aura with them. They carry an aura that tells me... I'm going to get the waves up here, you see. And it's a long time since I had... Now, I know that this belongs to a lady, and I know that this lady... I know that she wears glasses, and I think that it's probably the lady in the second row on my left here who owns whatever is inside here. Is this your handkerchief, madam? It is. Right, there's one. Would you give me another envelope, please? Thank you. And... Now, this time I get the sense of a gentleman who owns this, and this is a gentleman who is fairly, he's on my left. It's one of the two gentlemen up here, and I feel that this must be the gentleman over here, the gentleman in the third row, and you are not part of this, are you? I haven't paid you thousands of pounds. That is right. And you, sir, are the owner of this ring, this gold ring. Is that correct? That's your gold ring. May I have another one, please? And this time, thank you, we have, of course it gets easier as we go on because there are less people, but I shouldn't have reminded you. This is the lady, undoubtedly the lady in the orange dress, who owns whatever it is. I hope you've all put respectable things in these envelopes. No, we don't want any trouble. This is a family show. The last of the big spenders. 5p for the lady in the orange. Is it yours? It is yours. Right, with two left.
two left. And just, you're doing very well. And to save the anticlimax of number five, you can give me both these together, if you will, sir. Give me one in my left hand and one in my right. I have to kind of weigh them up. No, stop laughing, because I have to think about this. We've got two left, haven't we? We have got two left. Yes. I think that'll be right. No, it isn't. No, it's that way round. Yes. That'll be yours. Would you tear it open, sir? And that'll be yours. Tear it open. And if I'm wrong, well, there's a quick way out over there. It's very embarrassing if you finish up wrong. Do tear it open. Is that yours?
Yes.
That is your pass? That's, the American Express. Right. Shouldn't advertise. I should have said Harrods. I'm sorry. And is that yours, sir? You've got them all back. Fine. Thank you very much. Rolf, I wonder if you'd come over here for a moment. Yes. I'd like you very much to help me with a special kind of paint job. Would you put these on for me, please?
What are these for?
Four?
You've only got two, haven't you?
All right, what are these two for?
Well, you see, it's protection. I've got a pair as well. If you get magic paint on your hands, you could do yourself a mischief.
Are you getting me at it?
I wouldn't know how to start. Look, you put your magic gloves on, and I'll get the magic paint.
Okay.
All right?
Oh, hang on a sec. What are we going to paint on?
Nothing. We'll paint in midair.
Painting in midair? Magic gloves. You don't have to be crazy to be in show business, but it certainly helps. Hello. This should be good.
Good. Magic painting. Here we go. Look, watch this. See that?
I don't believe it. What are you painting?
An umbrella, of course. There.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Can I have a go?
Certainly. There's some more over there. Help yourself.
Right, I can't
wait. Here, I better just fill this bit in, Rolf, otherwise it'll leak, won't it? The rain will get
me. I still don't believe this, you know. It's impossible. Painting pictures in midair. It's just impossible.
Oh, no, not at all. The magic, you can do it anywhere, it's not impossible.
When you feel that strange compulsion, doing some raindrops here, dip your paintbrush in emulsion.
Aim at nothing, the emulsion simply rolls on.
It's impossible.
Squares are oblongs.
Squares are oblongs. We can paint them any size. It looks impossible.
It does, doesn't it? But they hang suspended right before your very eyes. It looks impossible.
Impossible.
So tomorrow, if you've half an hour to spare, just occupy it. Painting patterns in the air.
But when you try it,
just remember, without magic, it's impossible. Do you know, Rolf, wouldn't it be marvellous?
Wouldn't what be marvellous?
If a man could paint an opera hat in a magic kind of way, and then, without delay, produce a small bouquet.
Hey, I've got an idea.
Who's this?
Oh, come on, don't be that sort of stuff. Get rid of that. You've got to think big, David.
Think big.
If a man could paint a wall safe on a wall that wasn't there.
He's gone mad.
By magic, I declare.
Hang on a minute.
He could be a millionaire.
Oh, fantastic. I draw a door, and before the paint had dried, we find all kinds of things inside.
Look at that.
Now look at that. The crown jewels. No less. The orb and the sceptre. The swords.
Hey, swords.
Yes?
If a man could paint a magic trick, the way magicians do.
Of course, we put it on display.
Yes.
In a first-class cabaret.
Wouldn't that be exciting?
Yes. And we could use those swords.
Oh, I know the one you mean.
The sword.
Here, take a sword.
A sword.
I'm sticking it. That's it. The poor girl. Have another one. Oh, doesn't the time go quickly when you're having fun?
Yes.
There's one missing.
Oh, we need one for the middle, don't we, somewhere?
One in the middle?
Yeah.
I'll paint another one, Rolf. There we are.
Yes.
In the middle?
Yeah.
Oh, so there's a push through this. Then one by one, we both take the sword away. Then you and I
would simply say,
thank you both. Off we go.
Off we go. Ladies first, of course.
As they used to say in Variety, ladies and gentlemen, now you see him, now you don't. Oh, I enjoyed that. And speaking of Variety, here's somebody who really epitomizes the very soul of Variety. You haven't seen him on television in this country for quite a while because he's been traveling all over the world with his act. He's a very versatile gentleman, and his name, Derek Dean.
Marvellous, thank you. What a wonderful audience. Lovely. How lovely you all are. Do you like the Sioux Girls? Had it done special. Do you like the Sioux? I'll give you a quick look round the back. It's what they call the Italian cut. If I find the Italian that cuts it, I shall punch him in the ear. I went all round buying new gear. Went to Carnaby Street, I thought, for the show, you see. Got the tie. Do you like that? Do you like that? Not really my taste, but a lovely fellow owned the shop. Gladys, his name was. I'll have a word with Dave, I think.
Excuse me, Derek.
Yeah.
Forgive me butting in. Yeah. Look, this is not by any means a criticism, because it's always lovely to see you.
So far.
But what's happened to those marvellous whirlwind acrobatics that you used to do at the start of your act?
Oh, well, you can't start all that, you know, Dave. When you get to our age...
What do you mean, our age?
Well, all right, your age, then.
Oh, that's better.
When you're getting on a bit, you see,
yeah.
You've got to watch yourself. And I thought, don't knock your pan out. Do two gags and a song and get off, that's all.
Oh, but you used to do that marvellous bit at the start.
Oh, well, the way I used to open?
Yeah.
But I didn't get any more applause than that.
Oh, you did.
I'll prove it to you. Announce me again.
Oh, I'll do it with pleasure. Ladies and gentlemen, that remarkably versatile man, Derek Dean.
Can't do that anymore. Two gags and a funny song, get off, that's all.
What sort of gag did you do?
Oh, well, you like them. Did you hear about the trapeze artist that caught his wife in the act?
No.
That's the joke.
Oh, you don't think you were better off with the act?
No. When you get to our age, you can't do all that physical stuff.
I know. Time tells on a man, doesn't it?
Yeah, especially a good time.
Yeah.
I mean, the footballers, they get over 30, they pack it all in, you know.
Do they?
Ooh, it's all that kissing. That's what it is. Not good for them. And I noticed when I came back, Jackie Palo, he stopped, hasn't it? He's gone into show business.
Oh, come on. You're not going to tell me you've cut out the wrestling bit.
Oh, can't do that anymore.
That was one of the funniest bits of your act.
Oh, you mean with the...
Hey.
Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Keep smiling. All right.
Sorry, Steve. Can't do that. Can't do that anymore. Two gags and a song. Get off.
Yeah. Hey, but you're not going to tell me I wasted my time finding these for you because I went to a lot of trouble. You remember what you used to do with those?
I beg your pardon? Been a long time.
No, but you did it very well.
We used to put this in your mouth like that, you
That's
see?
Right, yes.
This was hard work, this.
Yeah.
How? I heard a ball. In the hottest. Hottest of ball, it goes, higher ball.
Well, go on then.
Oh,
show us.
Into the multitudes. I'm looking for a kind face.
Yes.
What a lovely lady there. Dear old lady. Thank you very much. Hello. No, I can't do that.
No? No more?
No, I can't do that anymore.
Well,
hand in the pocket and two gags in this.
As long as you haven't cut out the dance routine, Derek, because that was
the
super.
Dance?
Oh, that was so good.
Do you realise how much work that caused everybody?
Well,
you've got to travel your own tap mat, your dance mat, a big thing. About that size. About that size.
I
just
a minute, Derek. That's an antique Chinese screen. That's 200 years old.
David, if it was new, I wouldn't do it. No, you used to always count them in, you know.
Oh, that was to get the tempo, was it?
Well, the first one was to wake up the musical director. He was usually playing chess with the drummer. Right, are you ready? One, two, three, four.
Speak to me. Say something. Oh, he'll be all right. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Rolf Harris time.
Oh, what's that? Oh!
Can I get you involved in the song with me? Do you feel like singing today?
Yeah.
Tonight, this morning, this evening? Would you like to do it? The chorus, have a listen, it goes like this. Up a tree, fiddly diddly, up a tree. That's easy, all right? And then there's another bit. That's the place. Oh, that's the place for me. And I've got a couple of lines like, when the golfer does his nut, you can bet he's hooked his putt. Up a tree, fiddly diddly, up a tree. That's it, you come back in again. All right, you happy with that? Well, when we get to it, hop in, because it's a lot of fun. Okay, one, two, two, two.
Your life, you do your thing, you take it as it comes, until you strike adversity and fingers turn to thumbs. I know advice is hard to take, but take a tip from me. When circumstances get you down, the place for you to be is up a tree. Parking fines to pay, and you can sit there night and day. Up the tree, fiddly diddly, up the tree. All right, so far, very good. The other day I took me girl to stroll around the farm. A bull went mad and smashed the gate as we stood arm in arm. She started screaming, help me, save me, I don't want to die. I didn't run or panic, lads. Where was I? Up a tree, fiddly diddly, up a tree. This is it now, what's the matter with you? That's the place for me. When the bull came charging round like a man, I stood me ground. Up a tree, fiddly diddly, up a tree. I joined a Scottish regiment, that was many years ago, when suddenly the orders came to march to fight the foe. The cannon roared as we approached, and shot and shell flew high. But when they made their glorious charge, where was I? Up a tree, fiddly, fiddly, up a tree.
wouldn't cough, cause me sporran might blow off. I've always thought a nudist camp would be the place for me. Get a nice all over tan as brown could be. There's nothing there would bother me beneath the sunny sky. Unless perchance you mention, there's a spider on your fly. It's just a shot. Hang on with everything you've got. You get scratched in lots and lots of unexpected spots. Oh, by the way, if you're smoking, put your butts where the squirrel.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to finish with a rather spectacular illusion. May I just make the point, very important, that you people at home are going to see exactly what the people in the studio see. This is not a camera trick. It is a bit of stage magic. Rolf, would you be kind enough to come and help me? I hate to make you work again so quickly.
All right.
I think you'll enjoy this one.
Yeah.
A cage, an empty cage that opens like that. And we need a beautiful girl for this illusion. And I'm going to ask Lynsey if she'd come and help us again. Would you come and help us, please, darling? That's very kind.
David?
Yes?
David, why have you made me put this on?
Why are you dressed like that?
Yes.
Well, there's a very good reason, which I would like to keep a secret for a moment. So if you just... Can you guess what you've got to do? One foot on there.
The Rolf Harris.
Yes, madam, yes.
Oh, the way. That's it.
Lovely.
And we're going to contain you by sat in the front of the cage like this. And if you're comfortable...
Do I get fed?
Yeah. It's £10 a week with breakfast.
I'll take it.
Right. Then this goes over the top like this, Rolf. If you would pull this over here for me.
Bye.
Just pull that over the front. That's lovely. Pull it down nice and square. And let's swing it around, Rolf, so that they can see it all the way around. And take the top off, would you?
What?
Just pull it back like that and throw it away. Yes. Come on, Daniel. That's it. There we are. Rolf. Thank you very much, Rolf. And thank you, Lynsey. I thought you were fine. Thanks to Derek Dean and John Clocks. Thanks to you for watching. See you next week. Thanks a lot, Rolf. Come on, Lynsey.